if I can hit this. All right, we'll try. All right, here we go. All right, I'm committed. I've cut to my card. Tell everybody, what was the card that you merely thought of, that you never even touched in the deck?
Three of diamonds. No.
I told you it was good when it hits. Stage name is Kristoff the Magician, spelled with one K and two F's. And my real name is Chris Harristhal. And once you hear how my last name is pronounced, you can imagine why I use a stage name for the magic. I was born in Bloomington very long time ago, decades ago. And then my father always wanted to live in the woods, so we left Bloomington in 1973, and we went into the canoe outfitting business, ultimately outside of Ely, Minnesota, where I went to high school. And then I came back down to the cities for college and law school, and then of course started working for Larkin Hoffman right here in Bloomington again. I joined Larkin Hoffman in 1987 and finally decided to retire in about 2019 from my shareholder status, continued to work as a contract lawyer for a few years, and have now pretty much punched out entirely. But it has been a great, great firm to practice with. Wonderful people, good lawyers. It was a fabulous career. I started working in a bar doing magic when I was 12. My parents owned the bar. And that gave me an opportunity to develop the skill set required for professional magic. And then when I came back down for college and law school, I continued to work mostly in restaurants and bars doing magic. But then eventually the practice of law became a little bit too busy and magic had to settle for a hobby backseat. And then in about 2019, not knowing that the world was about to shut down, I decided I'm going to retire from law and just do magic. So that was great for a few months, and then of course everything closed and my magic had to go virtual like everybody else's entertainment did. But since that time, it's opened up again, and now I get to travel all over the country and a little bit abroad, doing magic for largely corporate groups, but also some public shows here and there. My show is not so much about what they call card artistry or other forms of that intensity. I want it to be entertaining. So when I do a show, there's gonna be a lot of humor, a lot of audience participation, and everything from sleight of hand, particularly in the close-up magic, to mentalism, to full-size stage illusions. My assistant is also my wife. And, you know, she married me when I was a lawyer, right? And now she's married to a guy who shuffles cards for a living. So she's had a fairly remarkable transition, but is being a good sport and is very comfortable on the stage herself. People are sometimes struck by the transition from lawyer to magician. They both involve storytelling. But in a courtroom, you talk, you argue. When you're doing magic, it's more complicated than that. There's sleight of hand, there are props, there's stage management, blocking, all kinds of things that can go wrong beyond what you say. So you still have to be mindful of the story that you're telling, but you also have to get people entertained, make them laugh, not just convince them. So magic really has a lot of challenge. The kind of pressure, though, is much different and very pleasant.